Hi and welcome to Extreme Science. This is Aya Chaura and this is the first episode of Extreme Science. During this episode, we're going to talk about what was the real story behind the discovery structure of DNA and who was the real one who discovered the structure of DNA. So let's find out. Stay tuned. The discovery structure of DNA was the most important scientific achievement in the last century, well, in human history in fact. Now, the famous double helix structure is almost synonymous with the Watson and Crick, the two scientists who won Nobel Prize for figuring it out. But there is another name you may know too, Rosalind Franklin. You may have heard that her data supported Watson and Crick's brilliant idea, or that she was plant-dressing belligerent scientists, which actually how Watson described her in his book The Double Helix. But thanks for Franklin's biography, who investigated her own life and interviewed many people close to her, and now we know that account far from true, and her scientific contribution have been vastly underplayed. So let's hear the real story. Rosalind Franklin was born here in London in 1920. She won scholarship to Cambridge University to study chemistry, where she earned her PhD here. Later, she conducts research on the coil that led to better gas masks for the British during the World War II. In 1951, she joins King's College to use X-ray technique to study structure of DNA, then one of the hottest topics in the science. Franklin upgraded X-ray lab and got to work, shining high-energy X-ray on a tiny water crystal of DNA. She clashed with Maurice Wilkins, her lab mate, who assumed that Franklin had been hired as his assistant. In 1952, she obtained photo 51, the most famous X-ray image of DNA. Just getting image took 100 hours, and the time that it required to analyze it will take a year. Meanwhile, the American biologist, Jim Watson, and the British physicist, Francis Crick, were also working on finding the DNA structure. But without Franklin's knowledge, Wilkins took photo 51 and showed it to Watson and Crick. It was really mean by him by doing that. So instead of calculating the exact position of each atom in the DNA, they did a quick analysis for DNA and they arrived to the right structure of DNA without any further effort. Eventually, they're up to the right one. DNA made of two helical strands, one opposite the other, with the bases in the center like a rungs of a ladder. For that, Watson and Crick published own model in April 1953. Meanwhile, the Franklin had finished her own calculation, came to the same conclusion, and submitted her own manuscript. The journal published their manuscript together, but with Franklin last, making her own experiment just confirm Watson and Crick's breakthrough. But Franklin had already stopped working on DNA and died of cancer in 1958, never knowing that Watson and Crick had seen her own photographics. Watson, Crick and Wilkins won Nobel Prize in 1962 for their work on DNA, and it's often said that she would have been recognized by a Nobel Prize if they could be rewarded posthumously. In fact, she could have been won twice because her work on a structure of viruses led to Nobel Prize for a colleague in 1982. That has led us to the final conclusion. Did they deserve it? Well, in my perspective, I can't tell, but let me know your perspective in the comment below and I'll be sure to follow up with you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and put a like. See you in the next time. Bye for now.